Hey guys, this is a follow-up review to my Little Swift review, and in this video I'll include some specific information about the small yarn stuff sack that comes included with the Little Swift. And this time around I've got my Little Swift pack pretty full, and even though it's full, there's still, you can push in at the bottom quite a bit, so I could fit several more things down there in the bottom as long as they weren't too bulky. So I'll open it up and show you what all I've got in here. I have three knitting projects in this bag right now. I have a cotton dish towel in progress. I have a wingspan shawl in progress. So, and I also have a pair of fingerless gloves in progress. And one thing I like about this bag is that it does not zip shut, because you don't want, you know, zippers catching your knitting, because that would be really bad. So, this bag does have a closure that buttons shut. So you think, well, my things aren't going to be as secure in a bag like this, but that's totally not the case because of the O-rings that come with it. And originally I said there were four, but there are six total with this bag. One at the top of each side, and one at the bottom of each side down here in the interior. So that's the third one, and this is the fourth one. I've got my camera clipped to that one. My wallet, as I said in the other video, I keep clipped to the key, included key strap that comes with the Little Swift. I like to keep my wallet attached to that one. So that's the camera case. I also have, let's just get everything out. I keep my iPod Shuffle in a carrying pouch for one of those reusable bags. I just clip that to the side of that one. So we'll get that out of the way. And here I just have some personal stuff in this zipper pocket, and this is what I forgot to include. Let's see how well I can open this up with one hand. This is what I forgot to mention in my first video, was I did not realize there are extra O-rings in the actual zipper pockets. They are tucked away under the flap here, so they're out of the way if you don't want to use them or don't need them. And there they are if you do need them. So each zipper pocket has an O-ring in there also, so that means there are six. Okay, what else do I have in here? Garage door opener. Fingerless glove. I have knitting, and this is the mate to that. And you can knit, you know, as long as you don't put your Little Swift, put too much in your Little Swift, you can knit straight from the bag. But I like to take out the little pouch and use it as my little knitting project bag. So, I also have in here lotion, a notepad, small tripod for the camera, and now it's kitty pen, papers, and that's another thing I found. You can take your papers and you can slip them up behind these plastic pockets here, and they will stay out of the way, and they won't get it damaged. Okay, so now it's empty now, except for the stuff I have in the pockets, and I don't have very much in the pockets. On the knitting side, I keep this as my personal stuff side, and this is the knitting side. So when the bag is completely empty, it does tend to deflate. But when you put everything back in, it does help it keep its shape. And this is the Cordura fabric. I hear the ballistics nylon is a bit more stiff, and it will stand up a little bit better on its own. Now I've got a couple things back in there, and it stands up much better. So, like that. See? So, the Cordura fabric is not as stiff, like I said, but it's really, really nice. It feels nice, and it's very pretty. And this is the Azalea colorway. Okay, so, let's get to the yarn stuff sack. It's hard to hold a camera and do things like this. Here we go. Okay, so I have a little glove in progress in here. I'll just pull that out. And a really cool thing about the yarn stuff sack is it comes with this handy little thing called a yarn guide on the side. So it is stitched into the side of the bag, into the stuff sack. And you can open and close this to allow your yarn to go through here. So when you've got your ball of yarn in here, sorry about the focus there, you've got the ball of yarn in here, you can pull as you need more yarn. The yarn guide keeps the yarn from going all over the place and getting tangled up. And as you can see, if you've got a center pull ball, this is a little bit simpler, but this ball was not center pull. I didn't choose to knit from it that way, so the ball freely rotates in the stuff sack. And the yarn guide keeps your yarn from getting all tangled up. And the sack stands up by itself very well. This is the Dyneema ripstop fabric in steel. And this, again, this comes free with your little Swift, one of these little sacks. It has a fabric bottom. You can get other ones that have clear bottoms so you can see what's in them without having to open it up. But this little thing is so nice. And, you know, it's a secure closure, but you have to push on it a bit to open it. But you feed your yarn through there, and it keeps it organized. So, all in all, I'm quite pleased with the little stuff sack, which easily would hold. It would probably hold a small shawl as well, or a medium-sized scarf. It holds this fingerless glove project pretty well, but you have to be careful when you're putting your DPNs in there that you get everything done in there straight. But this fabric is very sturdy. I have not had any issues, and these are very sharp double-pointed needles from Signature. They don't poke through the bag. This is very, very sturdy fabric. See, look, I'm pressing against it with the needle, and it does not poke through. So, very satisfied with that small stuff sack and with the little Swift. And also, anywhere on this bag that it has needed reinforcement, you can see the double stitching on there. The stitching is not just standard stitching. Like here, you don't need too much strength here, but here this is a join, so it's extra stitching on all the joins, which is really nice. The handles are also padded, and they feel really great. They slip on your shoulder. They don't fall off. I haven't had any trouble walking around with it and juggling a couple other bags and objects at the same time. So I say if you really want one of these, go ahead and go for it. It was really tempting to add a couple of extra stuff sacks to my order, but I couldn't afford it. So I think when next time we are able to visit my parents in the States, I'm going to put some little stuff sacks in medium and large and have them sent to my mama. But, yep, that's what all I had in there. Two projects, a bunch of personal stuff, and three projects, including this one. And, yep, it all fit in there really well. So, there you go.